Let's talk clothes. When living a more minimalist lifestyle, clothing definitely plays a very big role. So we're going to talk about how to organize it, how to go through it a little bit, and just kind of give you a little insight of what we do here in our household to have a more minimalist life through our clothing. Welcome, I'm Katarina. If you're new here, we talk all things sustainability, environmental tips, gardening, all things that are going to help you live maybe a more minimalist, more zero waste lifestyle that is accessible and sustainable for you and your home. All right, let's start with kids' clothes. I think that's a little bit easier. With kids' clothes, you definitely want to try and involve your child as much as possible. And depending on the age group, they're going to have a really big say or not. I'm going to start here in my daughter's room. My daughter is 3 years old.
All right, let's start with organization. So this is a small dresser from IKEA, potentially meant to be a nightstand. I don't know, but it's about 6 to 8 inches deep, not very deep. And right now we have all her shirts at the top, all her pants, underwear here in the bottom. So it's like as if she was getting dressed, top, bottom, I don't know, middle, I guess. And then her socks are here at the bottom. And then she has her pajamas as well. We kind of try and do the Marie Kondo method of kind of organizing and folding, where everything's in these little containers. They're facing up, so it's easy to get to. She can see what she owns really easily. These are all her pajamas. These are all her socks. We do have them just kind of living together. These are the fuzzy, slippery type socks. And so those are the bottoms. Then we have pants. Right now it's springtime, so she has her shorts in the back where it's not necessarily easy to get to because she's not necessarily needing to wear them. Underwear is right here, and then all of her pants. She doesn't wear jeans very often, so I just have two of those. She loves the legging style pants. When I'm looking at her clothing, I'm asking myself, like, what does she wear? And we talk about, like, she would not want to get rid of this, and we wouldn't get rid of it for a long time, but she would be totally fine to get rid of this when we do go through and donate those. We just did a big switch because it is springtime, and so we have a lot of, for example, these are her only long sleeve shirts right now, and earlier we had a bunch of long sleeve shirts and only a small amount of short sleeve shirts. We went through and donated the long sleeve shirts she's not going to wear anymore that were too small, that she doesn't really love, these ones she's always wearing, and then we put together the short sleeve shirts. Now with the short sleeve shirts, she hasn't been wearing them because it hasn't been warm enough. And so what we'll do is we'll kind of take note of what she's wearing and not wearing and kind of talk about donating those to other families. With my daughter's clothes, there is a variety of clothes. We offer literally everything to our daughter and say, hey, like, here are all your clothes. If we were to walk into a store, here are all your clothes. What would you like to choose? And she does love her dresses. She absolutely loves her dresses. And anything that is brothers, we also offer. And if she wants to wear those, she does, and or she doesn't. It's just definitely her choice. Again, same thing with her dresses. These three are long sleeve, and I know that she wears them pretty regularly. And then these ones are all short sleeves right here. Again, she just got them into her wardrobe, so I don't know which ones she'll wear or which ones she won't, but we'll try to keep note. And these are rompers, which I, again, don't know if she'll wear or not. Then I've got sweaters here at the top, and then we've got these overalls. And now that it's warmer weather, she may or may not wear them, I'm not sure. So that's my daughter's wardrobe. Again, shoes are over here. And most of her wardrobe is secondhand, so a lot of these are from another home, and they were offered to us, and we said yes, and we let her go through which one she wants. And some of these were gifted to her from other family members. Yeah, again, just allowing her to keep what she wants and donate what she doesn't, and just kind of keep it very easy for her to see. It's not overwhelming. That's kind of the key. All right, so here we are in my son's room. My son is 6 years old. He has the same size dresser as my daughter does, although his clothes are getting a little bit on the larger side, and so I don't know how long they'll be staying in this dresser. I'm not sure. So I'm going to go through again the organization of it. Same thing with my son. We offer all clothes to him, so if we get something that's a size that's in his size, either like gender, whatever, including dresses, like we offer everything to him and just say, you know, what do you want to wear? And we allow him to just kind of pick what makes him happy.
A big part of kind of that minimalist lifestyle is not feeling overwhelmed by all of your things, not feeling like knowing that everything there is something that just really makes you happy. And when we get to my clothing, I'll talk a little bit more about that. But my son in particular, he has SPD, sensory processing disorder. And so his wardrobe includes things that he loves and that he's going to wear. It's not going to be things that we ask him to wear. So again, with both of our kids, we try to remove ourselves and allow them to kind of curate their wardrobe and offer what we can to like offer and just continue to do that. All right, so with my son's wardrobe, it's the same thing. This is shirts, tops, this is underwear and pants, and then at the bottom is socks and pajamas. Same organization.
All right, so here are all his shirts that he wears. And so every single shirt in here is one that he wears on a regular basis. And he absolutely loves. And he is very particular and will not want to get rid of them. So any shirt that I consider like, hey, buddy, like this one, for example, hey, you don't really wear this very often. Are you ready to give it to another family? And he will say yes or no. And then we respect what he says and it lives here. So again, Marie Kondo style where it's all upright so he can see it. And this is, again, all of his clothes. It's not that deep of a drawer. It's not overwhelming. There you go. For my son, again, there are the sweats. There's another sweat back here. And then there's some shorts. Here are all of his underwear. But there you go. Pajamas are another thing that he is very particular about. So here are his pajamas that he wears. And then his socks as well. Same with my daughter, some slipper pajama style ones.
All right, so that's basically all my son's clothing. He does have one little basket right here, and this is clothes that have been gifted to him that he does not want to wear. And they're all too big of sizes anyway, so what I've done is I just keep them here available to him, and we just kind of explore them every now and then again because of that sensory need. He touches them, he feels them, we pull them out, we try them on a couple times, and we kind of keep, again, we do try and keep the stuff that he hasn't grown into yet available so that he can kind of, I don't know, explore that, I guess. Once he's in this size and he still is not okay with the texture of them, for example, these jeans, it's very likely he will not want to do that. There's this one here that has a very unique texture to it. He probably will probably end up just donating those as well. Yeah, that's literally all of my kids' clothes for the most part that they wear on a regular basis. So something I notice with kids that's different than adults is that oftentimes they are either growing too fast and they outgrow something really quickly, or you're gifted or given things and they're not quite ready to fit in it yet. And so you have a lot of almost like transient clothing that's going on. And so I have the system that I use to kind of go through it. And one of those is this is my son's container, and I'll show you my daughter's as well. All right, so something that I do for both kids is, and I've done this since they were really little, is I have two baskets, and sometimes I'll have a third one, and it will say next size, too small give, and then sometimes I'll have one that says too small pack, and I've kind of gotten rid of that one. I'll explain in a second, but next size is this clothing that they have been gifted, they've been given, we've been donated to us, like we've gotten secondhand, and it just currently doesn't either fit them because it's too big, or it is the wrong season. For example, all of her, right now in the next size, there's a bunch of summer stuff in here that are slightly too big. So once summer passes, that clothing then will not necessarily go back here, unless it is still too big and we think it might fit her next year. Her notice next size, there's no winter stuff in here because all of her winter stuff is most likely not gonna fit her when it becomes winter, and so they are in this too small give pile, which is actually very empty because I already went through it. But too small give is when something doesn't fit anymore or they don't wear it anymore. I just put it in this basket until it fills, which it was overfilling. So that's why I went through it. And then that's getting donated. This includes, again, seasonal clothing that I know they're not going to wear next season. This includes clothing that I'm going to donate because they don't wear it, because again, I'm trying to keep things in here that they are gonna wear, that they want to wear, that they enjoy.
With next size for my daughter, this is where my son's clothing goes. So that's why I don't have a pack category, because my son's clothes, when they're too big or too small, I put them right here in the next size, and my daughter can go through them when she's ready, and then they go in here to the give and donate section. So that's kind of the transition and how that works. All right, so let's talk about my clothing and my husband's clothing. So much different than our kids. For us, we keep kind of this wardrobe, and we do have some seasonal stuff, and I'll kind of get through that. But in general, when I'm looking at my clothes, I'm gonna ask myself, like, what are the things that I want to wear? What are the things that bring me joy? What are the things that fit me well, that when I'm wearing them, I feel good about? And this is a journey, definitely, that happens, I think. And I think everybody is gonna struggle differently in their own way when they're doing it for their wardrobe, whether it is their kind of disattached, whether it has negative impact, whether it like there is going to be something. So just be mindful of that when you do begin like going through your clothing. When going through your clothes, again, asking yourself kind of like what you're going to use. What's really challenging is that sometimes clothes. Well, sometimes I'll wear that. So really think about when is the last time you wore it, and ask yourself, can you borrow somebody else's? Is that an option? A lot of people are like, well, I don't want to go out and buy something new for this one occasion. And you're right, you don't. But do you really want to hold on to it for that one occasion for every 10 years? Probably not. It doesn't need to live inside of your daily life as well. So, just really quickly, let's go through kind of like how my stuff is organized, and I'll kind of just give some examples as we go through. My clothing is a combination of secondhand clothes, but also clothes that I've had before starting this kind of zero waste journey. So in here I have my dresses. That's this section here. These are all my dresses and skirts. These are my like cardigans, and I've got one little like jumper jumpsuit casual thing. So these are my little sweaters. I've got five here, looks like. This is all my belts. And then over here, I've got all my shirts. And as you can kind of see, I've tried to do it by color so that it's kind of more aesthetically pleasing. You walk in and it's not just a mod podge, it doesn't feel overwhelming. That's my goal. So again, I've got all of my different shirts right here, and they're all, you can kind of see by the hangers, they've got clear spacing. They're not just packed in, and it's not overwhelming at all. It's just right here. There you go. So down here, I've got all of my jeans, pants. And they're all, again, organized by color, hanging up. And then these are all my like sweaters and coats, jacket type stuff. And again, everything in here is something that, like, yes, I wear this. Yes, I wear this. I wear this. I wear these things literally regularly. And all these things kind of are part of my wardrobe, if you will. Notice that the hangers, a big part of kind of what we've done is all the hangers are the same color. I think that also allows some kind of neatness and organization to it. I'm gonna go through now these like containers really quickly. So I've got kind of warm season stuff. So I've got this has all my shorts in it, and then some sweatshirts from the winter time. And it's spring still, so these will live here until it gets really warm and I don't actually touch them, and then they'll go up. This is some summer stuff, mostly my husband's, but they do include some hats in there. And again, nothing's overfilling. So it's not like I have an abundance. They're just living up there because I don't use them regularly, especially in the Pacific Northwest. And then up here, I've got all my holiday sweaters, again, not overflowing, cold weather, and then my swim stuff. This includes our kids' stuff, so that swim stuff will live down here once the sweatshirts. So I'll kind of do a flop of those. So there is all of our stuff. And then my shoes as well are here. There you go. Time for my husband's. I'll do just a quick preview. So my husband is a totally different person, obviously, but he uses most of these clothes here. And then over here are all his dress shirts. He currently has a work from home position, and so he doesn't really wear these dress shirts very often. So he has kind of been working through his dress shirts and deciding which ones he loves and wants to keep, and which ones that he is ready to kind of part with. So those are them. And then he's got his pants down here, and it's the same thing. He's got a ton of slacks from working at an in-person job and then transitioning to online that he doesn't really wear as often. But he wears these ones, you know, more often. And then I do have this corner is stuff that I do not wear often at all. And I'm just trying to decide of parting, how I'm going to part with it and stuff. Letterman's jacket. This coat I do wear. It's just living down here until it gets warmer. And then I have my husband's like tux stuff. All right, the last thing, the moment you've all been waiting for, the socks and underwear drawer. You notice I didn't have any of those, but I do own some. We had a dresser for a while and we decided to move it and put all our kids' toys in it instead, and utilize our in-bed storage. Yeah. What'd you get to see? All right, so this is what would be in a dresser, but is in just one big drawer here underneath the bed. And I'll just go through really quick. Yoga pants and leggings, some sweat loungy pants. There you go. Pajama-y type stuff. Again, lounge, but like cooler lounge stuff. T-shirts, socks, undershirt type stuff, underwear, and a couple bras. And that's it. Again, Marie Kondo style, where it's all facing up, nothing's overwhelming. And I regularly go through them and decide what to do, what I like and not like. In the wintertime, I have more warmer style socks. And in the summertime, I've got more cooler style socks and I kind of rotate through those. All right, husband stuff, much less. So, socks, underwear, lots of t-shirts, socks that he doesn't really wear very often in the back, but isn't quite ready to part with, shorts, and then lounge pants. And that's it. All right there, organized. And then when we go through them pretty regularly and say, you know what, I haven't really worn this in a long time, it's time to donate it. So there you go. All right, so that is everything. I really hope that you were able to find either an organization tip that really you wanna try and apply, or a system that works, whether it is how you're gonna go through your different clothes, or maybe just having an example of what it might feel or look like to kind of have more of a minimalist wardrobe. There is no rules for it. It is what makes sense to you, and you can continue to go through it. It's a process and a progress. This is not my wardrobe 2 years ago. This is a wardrobe that has taken time to kind of shorten down. Maybe some tips on how keeping that smaller wardrobe is just so much easier to maintain. It takes up way less space. It's less overwhelming. There's just a lot less anxiety when it comes to like putting your clothing on, especially with kids. You know, it's not a battle every morning to get clothes on because of just so many options. So hopefully you found something and you're ready to try it out. Thank you for living more sustainably. See ya.